clay can now be mixed with vegetation and turned into custom blended adobe they are skilled at shaping. Facing more than a month of construction, the couple gets to work. They keep a close watch on how big the internal space must be. It needs to accommodate a clutch of 2 to 4 eggs and an adult to incubate them. As the home takes shape, lots of other birds begin showing an interest in it. A saffron finch and a Kiskadee flycatcher will mark the location. One of them might use the place next year when the ovenbirds have moved on. But it's the shiny cowbirds that are getting too close. The glossy black ones are males. But it's the dull coloured females that seem most fascinated with the structure. The ovenbirds now spend almost as much effort defending the little house as they do building it. At last, the dome is almost finished. Only a large front opening remains, when the ovenbirds suddenly begin working on an intriguing internal structure. Inside the simple dome, the birds are crafting a remarkable foyer. A curved wall that will seal off the main section of the interior. But they leave an opening at the top of the wall that gives them access to the roomy inner chamber. The home now has an elaborate two-part entrance, a security measure that makes it easy to defend. It's a tight squeeze in and out, even for the owners. Both parents come and go. For the next 2 weeks or so, they will take turns incubating the eggs, shouldering the duties together, just as they have from the very moment they began to build. Building with adobe is an age-old practice. We humans have been using it for some 10,000 years. But imagine a much older architecture.